BoomRoom II mushroom grow chamber, optimized for fruiting edible medicinal mushrooms with enhanced humidity and fresh air exchange systems that allow you to grow a wide range of mushroom species. The BoomRoom II is sleek, functional, and adaptable, making it the most versatile grow tent for fruiting mushrooms regardless of species, substrate, or growing container. I'm Lou from North Spore, and today I'm going to go over this latest addition in the North Spore product lineup, including what is a BoomRoom and who is it designed for, tips on how to build, maintain, and use a BoomRoom, and how to dial in your grow using these systems to grow bigger, more impressive flushes of mushrooms. The BoomRoom II is an improved version of our last mushroom grow tent. It's fitted with all new humidity and fresh air exchange systems that allow you to simulate microclimates suitable for a variety of mushroom species. The BoomRoom is a great system for anyone aiming to grow mushrooms year-round with high yields and minimal space. It also aids in primordial formation, encouraging your mushrooms to fruit. It captures spores, keeping them out of your living space. It's sleek and space efficient. It has more space now, with 5 full tiers of storage fitting up to 25-pound fruiting blocks, and has double-stitched seams with a clear vinyl cover made from tough ripstop material for light penetration and easy cleaning. The BoomRoom II also comes with a larger, more powerful humidifier and fresh air exchange fan than our previous build. Now, humidity is introduced from the top of the tent, while the FAE fan filters out CO2 from the bottom of the tent, ensuring a constant supply of fresh oxygen-rich air. Another improvement from our last design is an all-new waterproof subfloor layer to better contain your growing environment. It also helps capture excess humidity you may experience in the growing process. And for those seeking additional automation, a float valve is available separately that will allow the humidifier to be linked directly to a water source for hands-free refilling. There are many more new and exciting features of this BoomRoom, which I can't wait to dive into. Let's start with the build. The first step is to place the spore floor in the desired location of your grow tent. The spore floor is designed to protect the floor from moisture, and it also provides a secure surface for the tent and its components to sit on. Next, build the frame. You can do this by fitting 3 long tubes between 2 plastic connectors. The middle support should be placed in the top opening, and a gentle twisting motion will help with positioning and overall tent stability. Then place 4 of the short tubes in the openings at the top of each corner, and repeat until you are at the last shelf. Next, unzip the cover and place the frame inside the tent. Fit the remaining support beams inside of the tent until it's taut. Then, place the extra floor insert on the bottom of the tent. You can use these ties to secure it to the support beams. Once you have a frame, place the shelves across the supports. A negative pressure setup will be created by exhausting air outside of the tent by attaching the FAE fan to one of the 2 side ports. I'll be using the bottom right port, but you can make adjustments based on your individual needs. Identify the intake and exhaust ends of your FAE fan by locating the arrow that indicates the direction of airflow. Place your hose clamp around the port sleeve and place the filter around the intake end of the FAE fan. This filter helps capture spores before it passes through the fresh air exchange system. Slide the hose clamp around the tent sleeve. Then use a Phillips head screwdriver to tighten the hose clamp in place. Your FAE fan speed can be adjusted with this speed controller. Simply connect it to your FAE fan. Then, using an S-hook or something similar, you can hang your fan speed controller from the loops at the top of the tent. We'll install your Micromister ultrasonic humidifier next. First, separate the water tank from the base and remove the styrofoam strip from inside the unit. Next, attach the included wheels to the bottom of your humidifier. This will help with maneuverability when the humidifier is full. Remove the water tank cover and take out the pieces to your directional mist nozzle. The directional mist nozzle can be assembled by fitting the pipe segments together with a corresponding connector piece. Your final assembly should look something like this. Place the base of your directional mist nozzle in the opening at the top of your Micromister. Then put the nozzle inside the port at the top of your BoomRoom II. You can control humidity inside the tent by using your MyController humidity controller. The MyController works by cycling the Micromister on and off to maintain the individual parameters. You can also use an S-hook to hang your humidity controller. Next, feed the sensor through the same port as your directional mist nozzle. Drape the sensor through one of the racks in the middle of the tent. Placing your sensor in a central position will give your MyController a more accurate humidity reading. Tighten the port sleeve around the directional mist nozzle. Then in a similar fashion, close the remaining port sleeves. If you're sensitive to mushroom spores, you can choose to redirect the air inside of your tent to the outside using this 4-inch duct. Foam board insulation can be cut to fit an open window. Cut a hole in the insulation to thread the duct through to the outside. Keep in mind that certain insulating foams degrade in direct sunlight. To make this installation more permanent, place plywood or a similar material on either side of the insulating foam. If you live in a warmer climate and have less need for insulation, you can simply substitute this material outright. From fully colonized substrates to beautiful flushes of mushrooms, when it comes to fruiting, growers credit their success to balancing these four conditions: fresh air, humidity, light, and temperature. The BoomRoom controls humidity and fresh air exchange, while temperature and light are determined by external factors. Let's start with light. Unlike plants, mushrooms don't use light as an energy source, but mushrooms are photosensitive, meaning even the smallest amount of light helps determine the shape and color of the mushroom fruiting body. Light can also trigger mushroom growth or indicate suitable fruiting environments. But on the flip side, too much direct sunlight can cause your mushrooms to dry out, die from excessive heat, or make it harder to control your other conditions. Growers who place their tents in environments that lack light, such as a closet, will use supplemental lighting. This could be house lights, a lamp, or UV grow lights. Growers who place their tents in open living spaces will generally position it in an area away from direct sunlight. The next condition is temperature. In nature, many fungi fruit in response to seasonality, such as a drop in temperature in the fall. This limits the period in which mushrooms grow outside. But indoors, you can grow mushrooms year-round by housing your BoomRoom in a temperature-controlled area. Your tent should be placed in an environment that generally stays between 55 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Though keep in mind that the exact range tends to vary between mushroom species. Once you've decided on where to place your BoomRoom, you can dial in your humidity and fresh air exchange systems to create that optimal fruiting environment. Like humans, mushrooms inhale oxygen while exhaling CO2. And in nature, CO2 levels help inform when and where a mushroom should fruit. Inside your grow tent, an abundance of fresh air will have the same effect. you can use the fresh air exchange fan to exhaust excess CO2. You can also use a carbon dioxide meter to get precise measurements of CO2 concentrations if you'd like. Your fresh air exchange fan works in tandem with your micromister to consistently uphold the environment inside the tent. This is made possible by plugging your humidifier directly into your humidity controller, which cycles the micromister on and off as humidity is needed. As the fresh air exchange fan pushes out CO2, it also removes humidity. When the humidity drops below a certain percentage, your humidity sensor will send a signal to your Mi controller to turn the humidifier on. Once the humidity reaches a certain threshold, your controller will turn the humidifier off. These systems will keep humidity in the tent between a specific range, which you can set ahead of time. Let's set the lower limit of this range. When the humidity drops below this number, your humidifier will turn on. To set, hold down the up arrow on your Mi controller until the red numbers begin flashing. Then navigate to your desired range. Once the numbers stop flashing, the limit has been set. You can check this number by quickly pressing the up arrow. To set the upper limit, repeat this process with the down arrow. When the humidity goes above this limit, the humidifier will turn off. A good starting range for humidity is between 75 and 85%, as most mushrooms will fruit fine within this range. To start with, we recommend setting your humidifier to half power and the fan to low power. An optional repeat cycle timer allows you to better control airflow by turning the fan on and off at intervals of your choosing. This can be helpful for certain species and can reduce stress on the equipment. Adjustments may be required depending on your specific needs. We encourage you to tinker and find out what works best. Keep in mind that condensation can form at low temperatures and high humidity levels. Some condensation and pooling may be part of the normal operation of your boom room. Given the high humidity needed for mushroom growing, pooling can occur in the tent and surrounding spore floor. Be sure to monitor your tent closely when setting a high humidity level for the first time, especially if your tent is placed in a cooler area. You can reduce excessive moisture accumulation by adjusting the relationship between humidity, fan speed, and temperature. Knowing more about the species you're working with, the different stages of growth, and the method you're using to grow can inform what parameters you use to best optimize these systems. We have plenty of resources available on our website if you have any interest in learning more. Over time, the components in your boom room will collect spores, so it's helpful to clean them every so often to avoid buildup and prolong the life of the components. Make sure to unplug your fan and humidity system before cleaning. You can use 70% isopropyl alcohol and a damp cloth for keeping surfaces clean and sanitized. Filters should be cleaned often. In order to maintain high levels of fresh air exchange, your filters can be washed by hand and reused over time when visible spore buildup is present. You might want to consider replacing them every so often. Similar to the filters, you can rinse out the piping for the humidifier and the black ducting when needed. The BoomRoom II is incredibly versatile, allowing you to take advantage of a number of growing methods while dialing in environmental controls. If you're looking to grow mushrooms in a smaller space, North Spore also offers the BoomerBin monotub, as well as ShroomTech, our all-in-one grow bag system. You could even combine various growing techniques within the boom room for more automated control of fresh air exchange and humidity. It's our hope that you will be able to grow a variety of mushroom species with the boom room too. Thank you for watching this video, and to support this channel, please hit that like or subscribe button. As with any North Spore product, feel free to reach out to us with questions and concerns and let us know how you like the boom room. Thanks for watching.